Hello there, guys, and welcome to another episode of Caddy Crafts. In this episode, we're going to be making a model Roman Ballista, which the modern crossbow is based off. So, with our similar materials to the catapult project, which you can find in the description below this video, we're going to have a go at making our very own torsion power ballista. Let's check out the materials and let's get started. Okay, so for this project, you're going to need the following materials. If you're making it in school, you're also going to need these tools. So you're going to need a junior hacksaw, a clamp, a bench hook, and a pair of goggles for safety. So, with those tools, you're also going to need the following materials. You're going to need a length of string. You're going to need a length of 5mm round dowel. You're also going to need quite a lot of this 1cm cross-section pine wood, which you can buy in bulk from Consortium or TTS, or you can just use square cross-section doweling, works fine as well. So with that out of the way, let's get started on our design. You're going to need to measure and cut the following pieces of wood. You're going to need to get a 20cm piece of the square cross-section wood, 2 12cm pieces, 5 3cm pieces, and 2 5cm pieces. Once you cut them, they should look like this. So with all your pieces cut, we're going to make a start on the front of our ballista. So for the front of your ballista, you're going to need your 2 12cm pieces, and you're going to need 4 of the 5 3cm pieces. And what you're going to do is you're going to be lining it up just like this. You have the edges of the front of your ballista like this, and then you're going to have your 3s just in the middle here with about a 3.5cm gap between these two pieces here. You want to leave about a centimetre gap here, which you can measure quite easy just by taking a spare piece of wood, holding it between, and then just pressing the pieces together. And what you're going to do is you're going to drill 2 holes in the middle at the top here and here, and the middle at the top here and here, just wide enough so that your piece of doweling can fit string can go straight through the top, attached to the doweling in the middle, which is going to be your firing arm on either side, and then come out the bottom end there. So you need to drill some 2 holes big enough for the string. As my string is roughly a couple of millimetres across, I'm going to be drilling a hole that's about 3mm wide to fit my string through. Okay, so we're back here. Here you can see in my 12cm pieces, I've cut 2 4mm holes. And you can see, if you look closely, I've actually lined those up. So I drilled through both the 2 at the same time to give me 2 holes for me to pass my string through. So the next step is going to be to line up our 12cm pieces so the holes are lined up, and then line up our 3cm pieces with a nice 1cm gap in the middle there. Then we're going to use our hot glue gun to add dabs of glue here, and here to press them together. And if you wanted to at this point, you could use little card triangles here to strengthen the joints. So once you finish gluing the pieces together, you should have your front piece looks like this. So you've got our nice holes on the top there, and we've got holes on the bottom there. Take 2 pieces of string, roughly 15cm long, and I'm using a old tack, but you could use a paper clip. You're going to wet the end, and then you want to pass it through one of the holes. And here's where your tack comes in. You use that just to gently push it through. You might find it easy to use a slightly wider nail. I'm using quite a thin one. There we go, out he comes. I'm going to pull the string through the other hole here. You might want to just gently twine that between your fingers to get it through the first part. This is one of the more fiddly parts of the project, but also one of the most important parts. So there we go, out he comes. Now comes the important part. Now you're going to loop it over one of the pieces of doweling, and then back through and back down, back out the other hole. You want to make sure that this loop here, which is around the doweling, stays in place. One trick you can do here, if you've got a needle with a wide eye, is you can thread the string through the needle. So you see there, we've got our little loop there, which is going to hold in place. You can thread a needle with your string, assuming it's big and the eye of the needle is big enough, and then just push it on through. There we go, tease that through. In case you can hear thundering of pauses as my cat's going crazy upstairs. There we go. So you can see that's pulled through nicely there. And your other piece is going to be tied on the ends just here. And what you want to make sure is you don't accidentally pull through there. One thing you can do here, actually, which is really helpful, is add a little dab of hot glue just on the end of your string. It doesn't need to be very long, just enough to hold it in place. And you should find that'll stop your string moving around. So you're going to tie that off and then repeat on the other side here, and then we'll pick up the video afterwards. So once you've attached your string here and here, you see I've taken my two 10cm pieces of towel, put them between the two pieces of string, and holding it sideways on, take your pegs and turn each peg 10 turns in the same direction. Then once you've done one side, do the other side, and once you've done that, you should find that the dowel is held in place by this tightly coiled piece of string. Now when you do that to the other side and turn them in the opposite direction, the same number of turns, you end up with what's going to become this drawing part, the torsion part of our ballista. Now one thing to note is, the first time I did this, the string snapped because I'm using fairly weak string. The thicker string you use, the more tightly you can turn it, and the stronger your ballista the stronger your ballista will be. So with that out of the way, it's time for us to attach our 20cm piece underneath, which is going to form the length of our ballista. So very simply, all you need to do is just take a dab of hot glue underneath that center piece there, and then line up your piece just there and make sure it's nice and flat. You want to make sure it is straight onto the body, and I'll try and move that so you can see. There you go, see it's straight onto the body. Allow that to cool. One thing you could do here underneath is use a little a card triangle here to strengthen that if you wanted to. I'm going to choose not to in this case, but you could. Okay, so with that bit out of the way, we're going to move on to our back piece. And this is the piece that's going to hold the little winder we're going to have right at the back. And that's simply going to be made up of our 2 5cm pieces and our 3cm piece, with a little 1cm gap at the bottom there. But before we do that, we're going to drill 2 5cm holes either side of our 5cm pieces here. So that our last piece of dowel, which is going to be our winder, can go through here. So with your 2 5mm holes drilled, if you hold the two pieces over each other, you can see right the way through, so we've got a nice clean cut there. So very simply, we're now just going to take off 2 5cm pieces. Then we're going to have our 3cm piece just between there, about 1cm up from the base. So just apply a wee dab of hot glue to the end of our 3cm piece. Press it onto this piece here. If you want, you could put a wee piece in there just to make sure it's a 1cm gap. Then apply a wee dab there and push that onto there, making sure it's lining up nicely, which it is, which is what we're after. And then just to make sure it fits, we're going to take our piece of dowel. So here we go, we got our piece of dowel, and as you can see, the piece of dowel fits quite snugly. You want it to fit quite snugly, because when you're turning it, you want it to be able to turn fairly well and keep the tension on the back here. So the last bit we're going to do for this step is going to be putting a wee drop of blue just on the end of our 20cm piece. Then pressing our piece on here, nice and firmly. And then we are well on our way to being completed. So once you've done that, you've got the main shape of your ballista. Our next step here is going to be to attach our piece of string either end here and here. Now you've got two options here. As the string's not going to be taking too much of the tension, what you can do here is you can just tie on the string loosely here and here, and then add a wee dab of hot glue, and then we're going to stretch it back and have a go at firing some sort of bolt. So our next step is we're going to tie the two pieces of string, one on here, one on here. So you want to stretch a piece of string which is just the right length to go across from here to here, with a little bit extra for tying that knot, and then we'll cut off the extra. So here we are back again. We can see we've got our nicely glued on two pieces of string. And now with our test, if we pull that back, you can see the torsion elements here are pulling back on the string. And when we let go, they pull back nice and strongly there. And when the bolt's behind that, it'll be pulled out the front of our ballista just there. Now, as you can see from the back here, is actually that's incredibly high compared to where these are. And this is where you can start to adjust where these are a little bit by adjusting the tightness of these. Alternatively, you could raise up a little platform here, which would line up nicely with the back of our ballista. And so for this one, we're just going to build up the platform a wee bit, and I'll show you how we'll do that. So apply a couple of dabs of glue under each of the pieces of scrap, and just press those towards the front, one towards the front, and one towards the back. Once you've done that, apply the hot glue in dabs underneath your 20 centimeter length here. There we go. Remember, the more glue, the stronger it's going to be, and we want a nice strong base for us to slide along. So there you can see, that's a much better height for us to work off. It even fits in nicely with our little rail at the back here. So let's give it a wee pull back. Pulls back nice and strongly, and we can strengthen that by tightening our wee piece of wood here and here. Very nice indeed. We'll even try it with a wee bit of dowel, and we're going to have a look and see if there's anything we need to improve on. So let's line up our dowel here. We'll place it here, get it in line, and let's see if it'll actually fire our piece of dowel out of the gap. Ready? Here we go. Fantastic. Straight through the hole, out he goes, and anyone on the other side is going to be in deep, deep trouble. So I'm going to stop there for this project. There's a couple of things you could do to extend it further. If you wanted to, you could have a little hook or catch or here, which ties back to here. And then if you wanted to, you could use a little, turn this into a bit of a crank at the back. It's entirely up to you. Alternatively, you can just pull it back and let it go. As you can see, it is pretty powerful. The more turns you do turn on this, the stronger it's going to be. But there you go, guys. Thank you very much for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed learning how to make a model Roman ballista. Sorry, my accent has slipped from English into Scottish through this video. Not quite sure why, but there we go. I was born in Scotland. But so here we go. Do let me know if you've got any questions about the project or anything else you would like to do with it, or any developments you've got. It might be a really nice link in to anything you're doing to do with the Romans or siege weapons. You could also do an investigation to do with forces, maybe how many turns you make in the torsion element and to how strong it ends up being with the force. But thanks so much for watching the video. If you enjoyed the video, then do check out the catapult video on the other side of my channel. There'll be a link in the little end clip at the end of the video. And if you did enjoy this, why not subscribe to the channel for more of the same in the future, and pop a comment in the comment section below if there's anything you would like to see more of. But thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next video.